Missions to other planets generate large amounts of data. And as time goes on, our ability to process that data becomes a lot better. And that allows us to go back, look at that data, and maybe find some surprises that we weren't expecting. And this is your SpacePod for Thursday, May 24th, 2018. Just when you thought we were going to have to wait until the next mission to Europa to learn anything new about the place that may have the best conditions for life off of Earth in our own solar system, here comes Galileo with some old data and some new computing tricks back from the dead in order to teach us a little bit about Europa itself. Now, Galileo was launched in 1989, and it arrived at Jupiter in 1995, and it did an incredible amount of work, and it helped establish that Europa was a possible harbinger for life in our own solar system. And over 20 years after the data was taken back in 1997, transmitted to Earth, and examined initially, a team at the University of Michigan decided to have another go with the modern processing techniques that we use nowadays. Specifically, data from Galileo's magnetometer, used to measure magnetic fields, and its plasma wave charged particle instrument showed an uptick in electrically charged particles. And this was over an area that has been viewed by the Hubble Space Telescope to be ejecting material into space. In addition, ground-based observations have found this area to be a relative hotspot compared to the rest of Europa's surface. Now, this comes on the heels of recent photo processing releases by amateurs of Voyager photos taken during the probe's encounters at Saturn, showing that the plumes coming off of Enceladus were visible to Voyager's cameras, but they needed the modern processing techniques that we use today in order to have made those plumes visible. This is great news to finally have both confirmations from Hubble data and the data of Galileo that flew directly past Europa. NASA's upcoming Europa Clipper mission and the European Space Agency's JUICE mission should have a solid understanding of where to look during Europa encounters and when to take that data, and very importantly, with which instruments to take that data with as well. This really shows the value of missions, in that the discoveries made by them are not necessarily done immediately. Who knows in the future what kind of capability we'll have with data processing, but there's plenty of it, and there's plenty more mysteries to still be learned. Now, make sure to tune in every Saturday at 1800 Coordinated Universal Time for our live shows. Or wait a bit and watch us on demand at youtube.com/TMRO. Now, last week's episode 11.20 had Troy McCann of Moonshot, an Australian space company incubator. And if you like the shows of tomorrow, consider helping crowdfund us at patreon.com/TMRO. Also, subscribe, like, and share us everywhere you can. So, until the next space pod, keep exploring.